On September 13th, 24 teams spent a weekend of creative blood, sweat, and tears making a movie together.
Participants in Madison's 48-hour film project have just that, 2 days to write, shoot, edit, and produce a completed film in a genre that is selected at random.
The screenings of the film is this Friday at the Highway 18 Drive-In Theater in Jefferson. I love that. Michael Keeney is the Madison producer of the 48-hour Film Festival. He joins us now. Michael, thanks for being on the show today.
Michael, good to see you.
Thanks for having me. Good to see you both.
The drive-in theater thing is brilliant.
We really looked around. We'll actually be doing checkerboard parking, so people will have 8 acres in which to spread out.
Oh, that's wonderful. Now, this year, tell us, for people who aren't familiar with the project, how are the genres selected? And I know you also had an extra issue this year because of the pandemic. So you threw that in the requirements as well, right?
Yes. Normally, we have a big gathering party where we all get together and the teams will pull a genre out of the hat. It might be comedy. It might be film noir. It might be horror. There are about 25, 26 different genres that they won't know until the first hour of their competition. This year, in an effort to be safe, we did that all digitally, and we had a wheel of destiny. They got to digitally spin a wheel, and then they could see, oh, looks like I got martial arts film. That'll be interesting. And then before they could complete or even begin their filmmaking process, we had them complete a safe sets certification. So they all knew what the best practices would be to complete a film within that time frame, to be safe medically.
And the teams have to write it, get actors, shoot it, edit it.
The whole thing.
The whole thing in 2 days.
Yep. All the creative stuff has to be done during that 48-hour window. They can do some things like find a location. Like maybe they'll know, and this year a lot of teams said, well, I know I'm shooting at my house. And that sort of thing, but none of the creative processes can be done in advance.
I didn't mean to interrupt you. Go ahead.
And then as an initial kicker, we always add 3 elements that they must include. There's a prop that they must include. There's a line of dialogue that they must include. And there's also a character that they must include in their narrative. So it really would be very hard for them to do anything in advance.
Boy, I just keep sitting here thinking,
mind-boggling.
What would we do, you know?
Exactly.
What is the quality of these films like?
It's amazing. People will think, well, geez, how good can it be? It's Wisconsin, and everybody's a volunteer, so they can't possibly be any good. The reality is there are a number of professional filmmakers in our competition. And this year, I honestly believe this is the best we've ever had. I don't know if it's all those quality filmmakers have been cooped up for 5-6 months and just needed to get their creativity out, but we have some really amazing stuff. For example, we have a claymation film. I can't imagine what it would take to do stop motion in 48 hours.
Wow, that's impressive.
Any COVID-themed films?
We had a climate film as one of the genres. And we had some films that used the pandemic as a plot driver. I don't think we had anybody that specifically said, well, my story is about the pandemic. Mm-hmm. We definitely had films and teams that took a look at the world around them and tried to make art out of that.
Do you choose a winner, or is it just about enjoying the experience of seeing everybody else's work?
It's amazing that Kat, my partner, and I are pretty much the only two people in this entire process that don't get a vote. There is a winner, and we have a panel of juried of professional filmmakers from around the country, and there will be one film that will advance from here to our international round of competition. And from there, there'll be about 10 films that'll actually make the Cannes Film Festival in France. But for us, we don't vote in that. We don't vote in the audience favorite competition, which will take place at the theater on Friday night. Everybody else gets to vote. We just get to sit back and be really impressed with the community that we work in.
Yeah, it is impressive work indeed. It is this Friday. Tickets are $12. Can be found on 48hourfilm.com/Madison Friday night at the Highway 18 Outdoor Theater in Jefferson.
Michael, is it rain or shine?
It is rain or shine. I talked to the theater owner. He said the only way we would not screen is if we had heavy snowfall.
So hopefully
it's 2020. Oh. Don't even say that.
Hopefully that won't happen. Michael, thanks for
talking to your people at the weather desk. Maybe put in a word.
All right. Yeah, we will.
We'll do what we can. Thank you, Michael.
Great to see you. Thanks for joining us today.
Take care.